through real quick up to the first 6th grade. Then I stopped until I was in 10th grade. Then I grew 4 inches in 1 year.
Mr. Johnson.
My niece, she grew the same way. Shannon's grown the same way. Grow real fast.
Thank you.
shall die an American.
I was born an American too, but my parents were not. They came here to find freedom, liberty, and opportunities for themselves and our family. And now we all have the same privileges as you.
We are Americans, and this is our country.
I was born in America too, and so are my parents. But when they were growing up, they didn't have the same opportunities your parents did. Now, thanks to the vision and hard work of many people like Abraham Lincoln and Martin Luther King, my whole family can enjoy freedom, liberty, and opportunities just like you.
We are Americans, and this is our country.
I was not born here, but this is my country too. My parents brought me here so I could have the same opportunities the rest of you enjoy. And now, I'm an American, and this is my country.
To everyone, a chance. To everyone, regardless of birth, a shining, golden opportunity. The right to live, to work, to be ourselves, to become whatever we can be. This is the promise of America.
This land is yours.
Thank you.
opportunities to become whatever we have the talents to be.
To do unusual things or traditional things.
Oh, to all those who helped make our country great, like the early pioneers and settlers who had the courage to get it started.
And those who gave their lives to protect it.
And our leaders who used their talents to keep us going forward.
That's very good. Thank you for all those excellent thoughts. Well, we have been singing and talking about the rights and privileges our country has given us. But let's not forget our own responsibilities. We owe our leaders loyalty, support, and our prayers. And even when we don't agree with everything they do, we owe our leaders respect.
We also owe it to our country to work hard for progress, freedom, liberty, and opportunities, and to continue to rid our nation of all the remaining inequities in our government.
But we must do this in the most peaceful way possible.
Not by might, of course, but by love and wisdom and a greater understanding of one another.
Today on a very, of course, warm day today. I'd like, before I go on, and announce two things. Again, to please join me with another applause. I just did an outstanding job. We have some events coming up in the next 5 days. And just to tell you about those briefly, which involves the fifth grade. On Friday, the 17th, our program, which was our reading incentive program this year, Preble County Jones and the Emerald Law, our students read over 2 million pages this year. And so there's going to be an event held at the Aukerman Complex on the afternoon of the 17th between Preble County Jones and Dr. Dew. And you have received permission slips, so if you'd send those back so we can transport the students over there for the event. The other event will be on Monday the 20th at 10 a.m. and you should have information either yesterday or today. These students all year have been involved in a program called Project DARE, and that is a drug education program. Officer Phil Smith from the County Sheriff's Department has put together an assembly program scheduled for 10 a.m. Monday at the high school auditorium. You also should have received permission slips either today or yesterday if you send those back, because we like to take the students there for the program. Again, my thanks to you very much for coming today. We do appreciate it. And again, have a great day. And again, students, thank you very much.
Job. They look just beautiful. It really made our program special, I think, today. So I thank all